गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ इन सोशल लॉ सोसाइटी लॉ एंड एथिक्स देर इज ए वन टॉपिक लेफ्ट दैट इज डिजिटल सोसाइटी एंड नेटिजन एंड इन दिस नेट एटिकेट्स देन कम्युनिकेशन एटिकेट्स एंड सोशल मीडिया एटिकेट्स। So we know that as a citizen, in the similar way, there is a one word that is a netizen. Netizen means the people who are working internet. So these are netizen. And in this, there are some etiquettes given by society. These are called net etiquettes. Means whenever you are using internet, you must follow some etiquettes. So there are some communication etiquettes, there are some social media etiquettes. So one by one we will discuss these. So there are some basic netiquettes or internet etiquettes. First one is make your people a priority. It's possibility that sometimes we discuss something with the social media and we ignore the people. So that is a bad practice. So we must give priority to every member of your group. Okay. So next one is number three. So there are some rules. We discuss one by one. Make real people a priority means give the priority to every person when we are using internet. Use respectful language for the internet user. Don't use the foul language or wrong language. Next one is share with discretion. It means sometimes we have one idea that is for a limited number of people, but we are sharing it with a large number of people. That is a wrong thing. Okay, so if you want to share any idea with a small segment of any group, just share with separately, not in a group. Then don't exclude others means don't ignore others. Then number five is choose friends wisely. It means whenever there is any friend request, there is any type of you are accepting the friend request or you are sending the friend request, be very wise. Means go through the profile, find out whether there is a genuine profile. So accepting friend request is very important. Next one is don't email large files. So suppose we are sending an email and it contains a very large file. In that case, the person who is receiving that email will not read your file. Next is respect people's privacy. So don't break the privacy of others. Clear? So don't try to get sensitive information of others. Next is fact check before reposting. So whenever you are reposting any post or you are giving a response or you are forwarding the response, okay, don't send it as it is. Before check whether that is a genuine information or not. So these and here these are the netiquettes. Means whenever you are using internet, use these rules. Next is email promptly. Promptly means quickly. So if you have received an email, it is a good practice to give the reply. Next is update online information. So update your profile, your online information. Sometimes information is very old one. So it is your duty to update your online information. Next is respect. This we have already discussed. So these are the 10 rules, 10 netiquettes or internet etiquettes. Any doubt on this, Himanshu?
Sir, no doubt.
Okay. Now there are some netiquettes linked with social media. It means whenever we are using social media, there are some rules, there are some etiquettes. These are don't mix business and the pleasure. Means sometimes we involved in a group that is for only fun purpose, and we are mixing use it for business purpose. Next is be use question posting and tagging photos. You should be very careful while posting and tagging the photos. Self-centered in small doses means that don't be so active that everything you are sharing, the little bit of control should be there. Don't be reactive. Reactive means don't give the reaction on every post. Be some patience in you yourself. Bring some patience. Next is avoid oversharing. So these things are overlinked. So oversharing of things are bad. Okay. Next is don't misrepresent yourself. So your profile must be correct one. Don't misrepresent yourself that I can do this or I'm doing this. Take it. Next is understand each platform best practice. So हमें किसी भी प्लेटफॉर्म में या whether it is a Facebook or Twitter, तो follow their rules, their best practices, okay? So there are some common netiquettes. These are be careful while posting. Second one is make your friends wisely. Third one is don't disclose everything in social networking. Clear? So these are the some golden rules. So this is with this your practical portion is complete. If you have any doubt, discuss with me. Angel, any doubt in this with us? Okay. Now we are going to start the revision work. So revision work is from list. Okay, first topic of Python is list. Then we will discuss tuple, dictionary, then Python modules. Then we will discuss number system and Boolean algebra.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर,
Yes, sir.
सर आपने जो फाइल्स दी है ना, आपने जो प्रैक्टिकल फाइल जो प्रोग्राम्स दिए हैं अपने
Yes, sir.
सर, उसमें प्रोग्राम नंबर 5 प्रोग्राम टू इंसर्ट अ टपल एंड है कि प्रोग्राम नंबर 5 है।
बेटा रिपीट दी आई विल सॉल्व दिस रिपीट दिस क्वेश्चन ओके हिमांशु रिपीट दिस क्वेश्चन एंड आई विल डिस्कस दिस
राइट अ प्रोग्राम
वन मिनट राइट ए प्रोग्राम टू
टू इंसर्ट अ टपल
इंसर्ट ए टपल
एंड डिस्प्ले
And
ऑल एलिमेंट्स
elements
which are divisible by 3.
Okay. You want coding on this topic, okay?
Yes.
I'm going to discuss. Okay, students, before getting the input of any tuple, we will have to use the eval function. Okay, so I am taking one tuple x is equal to eval input enter. A tuple elements enter tuple elements, then use for loop for traversing or assessing the elements of a tuple. I'm using for I in x. It will check one by one all the elements of tuple, and first element will be received by I, then second, then third, then fourth, and so on. If I percentage, here we want to display the elements which are divisible by 3. So we will use I percentage 3. Double equal to 0. It means if the number is divisible by 3, in that case you want to display that number on the screen. So we will use I. Okay. And if you do, if you want, the data must be displayed in the same line, then use end equal to single quote start space single quote close. And then print command close. So now I am going to display, going to run this program. So enter the element of the tuple. So I am typing here bracket 10, 5, 6, 4, 3. Here is 12, then 11, and then I press enter. So only 6, 3, and 12. These are divisible by 3. So this is the coding. Please note down the coding with us. Himanshu, clear?
Yes, sir. Sir, for loop, basically use hota hai for assessing and?
For loop, it is for assessing the element of any tuple or list. We will have to use.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Now, revision work, we are starting from list. Okay, so normally the variables we can store a single value. For example, x is equal to 10. It is a single value. But when we want to store the value in collections, it means number of values in some single variable, then we will have to use list, tuple, or dictionary. And there is a string. String is a part of your term 1 syllabus. So first is list. So it is a collection of elements. Clear? And it is, so now I am going to write the characteristics or features of a list. So list is the features hai, jo hum yahan pe bhi discuss karenge. Okay. First feature is, list is a collection. Okay. So list is, it is a collection. Clear? Second one. It is mutable in nature. So we can, it is mutable means you can change the value of any element. Okay. So it is possibility in the case of list. So during the your program, you can add any element in the list. You can delete any element from the list. Even you can change the value of any element. You clear? This is due to the nature, that is mutable in nature. Next is, here we can use only two arithmetic operators. Okay, one is called plus and it is called a concatenation. Okay, concatenation is joining, and second one is called into symbol. This is called replication. Clear? Application means repeating. So here we can use only two arithmetical operators. Number four. Here we can use square brackets. Clear? For defining the elements. So these are some features. Okay. So now we will discuss what is list. So list is a mutable collection of values placed within square brackets. Okay, so these are placed in a square bracket. So this is the definition of a list. So in Python, if I want to use list, I will have to give name of one variable equal to sign. Then in square bracket, different elements separated with comma. Like this, and close square bracket and then press it. We have declared one list. And if I want to see its data type, then the way is, there is a one function that is type. It is a list. So in list, we can add, delete, and modify the values of a different element. So there in the list, we can use different functions and methods. The first फंक्शन, इसमें आप कौन कौन से फंक्शन यूज कर सकते हो? नंबर वन लेंथ फंक्शन, नंबर टू मैक्स, सो ऑल ऑफ दीज फंक्शन वी कैन यूज. कैसे आपने यूज करना है इसको? So here, sum in bracket 8 list, then max, maximum value, min, minimum value, then length, number of element. Then there is a function avg. Oh, here is the average. No, it is not. It is a part of another number. So these are the different functions we have already. Oh yes, here is a length, max, min, and sum. These are the functions of your list. Now there are some methods. These are one more. First, I am going to create the list of these different methods. Then we will discuss these one by one. So, first method is. There is another function that is called list function. It is used to convert any data type into list. Okay, तो इसमें अगर आपने कोई भी data type ली है, suppose मेरे पास एक list है, that is R. Okay, yeah. So this is a list in square bracket. So suppose I am using here one list function, and inside this I am taking one string, and I am storing this value in variable x. Then I display x. Now this is a list. So my string is converted into list. So you can convert any tuple, any list, any. Tuple or a string into list. So आप list में convert कर सकते हैं. This is a list function. Now different methods we are going to discuss here. First is index method. Number two,
count method.
Append. Number
extend.
Three, extend.
Pop.
Then there is a pop.
Remove.
Yes.
Remove.
Sir,
count is not a count of one.
Huh? Count B. Six. Then next is your pop function, remove function. Clear. Count. Then reverse sort. This is a sorted. Sorted is a function. We will discuss later on. Sorted. Then. So these are the different methods. So index method is used to find out the index value of any element. So in Python, we declared one list R. So in this, every element having a one indexing value, place. Clear? Here is a zero, starting from zero, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the same way, there is one negative indexing. This is -7, -6, -5, -4, -3, -2, -1. Clear? So two type of indexing, positive and negative. So index method will tell us the index of a particular element. So here is, by default, it will show only the positive indexing. So R is here, and if I'm using R dot index, why R dot means it is a method index. Index it, I'm giving 22. It is showing which element the index is 2. 0, 1, 2. Suppose 22 is replicated in this list. It's mean duplicate value of 22. So it will show the first element index. So 22 jo pehle aayega, usi ka index. Student, any doubt in this? Amit, any doubt? Okay. Now, suppose next is append method. Append method is used to add one element at the end of the list. So my list ke end mein ek element ko agar maine add karna hai, to mujhe append function, append method use karna padega. R dot append, I give 78. So if I display R, one element is added. But if I am trying to add more element, like R dot append, I want to add 98, 87. So it will not accept the data. Clear? Because it needs exactly one argument. So if I am adding this element, these element in square bracket, like this, then there will be nesting, the list inside another list. So if this is a 10 is at 0 index, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In 8 index, the both elements are in the list. If I am displaying R8, okay, and now my question is, if I want to display only 87, yes, how I can display only 87? Isha?
Sir, R karke 8 fir 1.
Yes. R 8 and 1. At 0 index, there will be 98. At 1 index, it will be 87. So it is 87. Clear? So this is called nested list. And if you are going to add more element with the help of append method, we create a nested list. Okay, next is
sir.
Yes, sir.
सर जो बैकवर्ड इंडेक्सिंग होती है वो उल्टी शुरू होती है।
बेटा वो अभी मैं इंडेक्सिंग के क्वेश्चंस करवाऊंगा, ठीक है? तो आपको क्लियर होगा।
ठीक है। ओके सर।
कंसेप्ट क्लियर हो जाएगा।
ओके।
नाउ नेक्स्ट इज इफ आई यूज एक्सटेंड फंक्शन। तो आई कैन ऐड मोर देन वन एलिमेंट लाइक 101. I can add single element, but I can also add number of elements. Again, there will be error. Reason is, if I want to give multiple element, then I will have to use square bracket. Like this. So my elements are added, but it is not nested. They are separate. So if I display R, here is 101 and 102. So this is the difference between append and extend. Clear? So append is used to insert only single element. If we try to insert more element, there will be nested list. But in the case of extend, we can add number of element in the list. There are any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay. So Monday, again, we will continue the list. So we will discuss this chapter very deeply with us. We will discuss the back exercise questions. We will discuss the output programs, error finding. So
sir, Monday ko bhi online class hi hai.
But still, there is no any information. There is no any guidelines regarding that. But I think so that there will be online class.
Okay.
Okay. Now you will get the information regarding that. Okay, students, now time is over. Thanks for attending the meeting. I'm closing the meeting with a bye.